Whether money can buy happiness or not is a topic that many psychologists and behavioral economists have thought about for decades. Lately, researchers have tried to advise people to steer clear of things and invest rather in experiences. Well, there's no denying that travels, thrills, and new challenges can bring about great satisfaction and meaning to an individual. But material things shouldn't be dismissed entirely. It just so happens that they can make us happy too. But before we dive into how this is possible, it would help to look at what happiness is all about. It's been etched in our minds that happiness is attained when everything seems perfect, and so we pursue it every single day. Happiness is relative though, which makes it really difficult to define what it is and achieve it. What makes you happy might not be what makes someone else happy. Some people say it depends really on the kind of happiness a person values. It's one of those things that are personal to everyone. Happiness could be living in a comfortable house, driving a fast car, going to fancy restaurants, and so on. Happiness could also be being able to go to the beach and watch the sunset, eating from takeout containers, or living in a trailer park somewhere. Some people categorize happiness into two categories. There's day-to-day happiness, which you get when you're experiencing life. Then there's the broader life expectation, which you get upon reflecting on your life. To get a better picture, imagine you're watching a movie and you're really enjoying it. This would be happiness you get when experiencing life. But then, the ending is screwed up, and this ends up messing up your movie experience entirely. This is the reflecting part of you. These types of happiness are set apart using peak experiences. If you're wondering what peak experiences are, they're events that bring about intense emotions, positive or negative. These moments of intense emotions are the ones that usually stand out whenever you look back at the life you've had. So, going back to the relation between material things and happiness, Michael Norton, a professor of business administration at Harvard Business School and co-author of Happy Money, The Science of Happy Spending, says that most people tend to avoid material possessions, but it doesn't necessarily mean that all material goods you purchase don't make you happy. It's just that some things make us happier than others. A particular study published in Psychology of Science revealed that people receive greatest satisfaction on things that match their personality, indicating in some way that there is real value in certain purchased items. The researchers gave over 600 people questionnaires that were filled out anonymously, indicating their personality type and life satisfaction. The researchers looked at their bank transactions and noted that the happiest people in the study were those who spent more on services or things that were in sync with the type of personality they have. It was observed that someone who was more outgoing and social would spend more cash out in clubs or any other social setting, while a quieter, introverted person would be very much happy and content, spending money on books and the like. Another study that favors material goods showed that things indeed provide more long-lasting happiness as compared to experiences. The researchers followed up on people's level of happiness after spending money on material goods. The researchers discovered that the participants continued to feel happy even 2 weeks after buying a particular item. An experience, on the other hand, brought out an intense thrill while it lasted, but diminished with time. So, where does the phrase that money can't buy happiness come from? It's typically used by those who don't have money, and it's for this reason that they say this to themselves as a way to divert their attention from the fact that they can't pull themselves out of their financial situation. While some seek solace in this line, others go as far as saying that money is the root of all evil. Let us know what you think with a comment down below, and if you're liking the video so far, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. So, if this is the case, it raises the question, is poverty the root of all goodness, and what's right? Try mentioning this to a homeless guy on the street who can barely manage to have one meal a day, or a promising young student who has to drop out of college because his folks can't afford to keep him or her in school anymore. And it's not just the poor who are saying money can't buy you happiness. Even the rich have been known to use the same phrase from time to time, but not for the reasons that others do. They'll try to convince you that you shouldn't focus on money too much, but rather on following your dreams. You shouldn't listen to these guys. They're simply trying to make you believe that you're just the same, that you don't really need money to become happy. But they won't be there with you when you're struggling to make ends meet, pay your mortgage, repay a loan from the bank, or pay a huge medical bill. Researchers suggest that money relations are rooted in psychology. Daniel Kahneman, an American psychologist, found that after people make enough money to cover their basic needs, whatever amount of money they make after that doesn't necessarily make them any happier. It reaches a point where the only way your money brings happiness is how you spend it. Some researchers believe that the amount of money you have doesn't really change how happy you'll be. According to them, people always say that they would be happier if only they made more money. But a study was carried out in the University of British Columbia, and researchers seem to have a different opinion on the matter. When asked to take stock of their lives, people with more money report being a good deal more satisfied. But when asked how happy they were at the moment, people with more are barely different than those with less. This was published in the Journal of Consumer Psychology. But with time, new studies have been raised to the surface that argue otherwise. And according to these recent studies, the amount of money you make does indeed have a bearing on your level of happiness. An economics paper written in 2016 stated that one's income approaches the $80,000 mark, negative emotions go down at a steady rate. As one's earnings approaches $200,000, their negative emotions still exist to decrease, giving off the impression of a happier life. So in some way, the money you earn influences your level of happiness. So, if you look at it critically, you'll notice a majority of your most memorable experiences are linked to how much you earned. This could be at the time you got an increase in your salary, or when the money you made allowed you to experience new and exciting experiences, like flying first class to some tropical paradise. It's these experiences that trigger contentment and satisfaction when you look back. We're always told to pursue our dreams and not focus on money so much. But the reality that we all have to face is that dreams don't pay the bills, but money does. It's the only way our basic needs are met. No one's stopping you from achieving your dreams, but be realistic. Do some research on how someone in your prospective career path earns. Compare it to your expenses and decide whether you can make a livable income. If this isn't possible, try to compromise by looking for work that strikes a balance between your needs and what you're passionate about. The reason why money does buy happiness is because once you have it, you don't have to worry about it anymore. It's one less thing you have to think about. All the stress that's associated with the lack of money simply floats away. You're no longer worked up when your kid spills something on the car seat, for example, and you'll have to get it cleaned. Or your TV doesn't work anymore, so you'll need to buy a new one. And why is that? You can afford it now. Money buys you awesome memories. Most would say the happiest moments are spent with loved ones. But if you had enough money to take your family to vacation in Hawaii, wouldn't it make you happy? Even the fun moments you had learning how to do the tango or learning a new language must have cost money. The moment people start telling you that money can't buy you happiness, try taking a look at their finances. They're likely telling you this because they don't have money themselves, and so they haven't enjoyed the freedom that having money offers. And if they're rich, they're just trying to blend in and not look selfish. Of course, money alone does not determine whether you'll be happy or not. Other factors play a role in it. These could be relationships, satisfaction at work, health, and others. And you'll realize that for better health, you'll probably need access to better medical care, healthy foods, or even a gym membership. Friendships are better enjoyed if you're able to pay for dinners and movies when you go out. And when it comes to love, the likelihood of a divorce is fueled by arguments over finances, as stated in a study conducted by Kansas State University. There's also another way having money can make you happy. As counterintuitive as it may seem, giving to others can make you happy. How's this even possible? From a young age, we always want things that belong to us. A young kid won't believe that sharing their toy, for example, is a good thing, no matter how much you try to convince them. But the older we get, we realize how meaningful giving is. Giving brings double happiness. You get a feeling of satisfaction, watching others receive something they weren't expecting, and it also hinders us from holding on so tightly to what we have. Money can indeed make you happy. It starts by giving us the necessary things we need to live. But it continues to do so as it gives us the chance to use it to bless others and enjoy one another more. In summary, money can buy you happiness because money buys people peace of mind and opportunities to have memorable experiences. Don't allow someone else to ever convince you otherwise. Believe what you want to believe. Let us know your thoughts down below with a comment. And if you enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It really helps us out with the ratings. If you're new to the channel, welcome and consider subscribing for more content like this. With that said, have a great day, you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.